might want to call this the supermodel dog. Why? Its hairdo, of course. Long and lavish and perfectly parted right down the middle of its back.
And they have that flowing coat all the way to the ground where you can't even hardly see their feet.
It's a hardy breed that is lively and intelligent and whose body is longer than it is tall. Usually weighs in under 20 pounds.
It's a very popular dog because they're so adorable.
The Lhasa Apso is a diva in its own right, who's loyal to those closest to them, yet wary of strangers.
They like to deal with their general family. They don't like outsiders all that much unless socialized.
And it's this Lhasa Apso alpha type dog who does what he wants when he wants.
They kind of have a little stubborn streak.
The Lhasa Apso is a very old, ancient breed that originated in the tucked away mountains of the Himalayas. For centuries, the dogs were confined just to Tibet, where holy men and nobles kept the little dogs in isolation, where they performed as watchdogs. And in Tibet, they called the dog Apso Senki, which literally means bark lion sentinel dog.
It would bark to alert lion, its appearance, and sentinel and standing guard.
It wasn't until the 1930s that the Lhasa Apso made it here to the United States, after being given to us by the Dalai Lama himself.
It is a royalty type dog. It's a dog that loves to sit on the couch. It's a dog that if you don't exercise it, it's not gonna care, but you wanna make sure you do it anyway.
They're great dogs. They're prized.
The Lhasa Apso's coat is a feature you just can't miss. Double layered, long, heavy, and coarse, and covers its entire body.
These guys have this long hair that just droops over their eyes and droops right to the floor. They can rapidly become a dust mop.
And its fur comes in a bevy of colors, although most often seen are gold, cream, and honey, which highlight the dog's dark facial accents. And if showing the Lhasa Apso, its coat should be kept long.
But most families like to do a puppy cut, which is just a general uniform clip all over, and they look just as cute.
Another interesting quality is this dog's signature tail that flips up right over its back. Its ears, which hang low, are covered in feathered fur. They are super sharp and can easily pinpoint danger. But this little dog's voice is what makes owners stand up and take notice.
They're very smart, so if there's a problem and they notice something wrong, they're gonna let you know.
Meet Lulu from New Jersey. She's a typical Lhasa Apso with a big barking voice.
I not only worship this dog, I love this dog so much. There isn't another dog in the world that would be able to do what Lulu has done.
Hal and his wife Peggy adore little Lulu, along with all the neighborhood dogs.
Super Lulu. Lulu always does wonderful things. Everybody loves Lulu. She's queen in the neighborhood.
But life for Lulu hasn't always been so easy. When she was just 7 years old, she ruptured two discs in her back, which prevented her from being able to walk.
The vet told me that her spine was so badly damaged that they could not even operate on her. They didn't guarantee any success.
The vets told Hal he should put Lulu down. Hal said, no way.
As long as she wasn't in pain, putting her down was not an option.
Hal got Lulu into therapy and got her a wheelchair.
Lulu is a very feisty female. She was just determined that this wasn't going to stop her, and she knew I was going to be there for the long haul.
Eventually, hard work paid off, and little Lulu began to walk again.
I had a neighbor who said to me, "What happened to that dog that you had in the wheels?" I said, "This is that dog." She said, "Oh my God, it's a miracle."
But Lulu's story does not end here. When we come back, see how Miracle Lulu became Hero Lulu. Everyone, including Hal, could not believe it when his little Lulu began to walk again. But that remarkable development is not the end of this miracle story. Just a few years ago, Lulu snapped into action when her natural instincts woke her up and told her to wake the family. Everyone was snuggled into bed, sleeping soundly, when Lulu knew there was a serious problem.
I could hear Lulu on the edge of the bed going, and I thought, there must be something down there.
Lulu was right. The house was on fire.